Tamim Ad-Dari was one of the few Sahabi who was a Christian and then embraced Islam. The majority of Sahaba were pagans. And so Tamim Ad-Dari, he came to embrace Islam. And he came in the ninth year of the Hijrah. And when he came, he told the Prophet ﷺ about something that happened to him many, many, many years ago. The story goes as follows that Tamim Ad-Dari says when he was a younger man that he was in a ship of around 30 people from the tribe of Judham and Lukham. These are Christian Arab tribes up north, and he was from those tribes. And once a very severe storm came in the ocean, and for 30 days they were lost at sea. After there were 30 days, they were lost at sea. They had no clue where they were until they came to a faraway, you know, ocean that they could not recognize, and they saw an island in the distance. So some of them, Tamim Ad-Dari and a few of them, took the smaller boat to go get some water, to go get some food. So you know, every large boat has that small boat to go in. So they took that smaller boat to go to that island. And when they landed on that island, they met a very terrifying animal. A beast that could speak to them, a dabba that could speak to them. And the beast said, "Come with me, I'm going to take you to my owner or my master." And they went to this island, and they went to this cave where they saw a man larger than any man they have ever seen. And the man was tied up in a more severe manner than any man they have ever seen. Then he says that, "Has the Ummi Prophet been sent amongst the Arabs? Has that Prophet been sent amongst the Arabs?" And Tamim Ad-Dari at this time was a Christian, but he was an Arab. He knows the Prophet has come. So he says, "Yes, he has been sent. And he has come out from Mecca and he has settled in Yathrib." The Dajjal says, "Did the Arabs fight him?" They say, "Yes." So he says, "Who won?" They say, "Sometimes he wins and sometimes the Arabs wins," meaning the Uhud. Uhud, they say, was a loss, even though Uhud was not a loss. From our perspective, Uhud was a stalemate. Dajjal then said, "If there is good in the Arabs, they should follow him. And I will tell you about me. I am the Masih. And it is only a matter of time before I am let loose. And when I am let loose, I shall visit every single city on earth in 40 days, except for Mecca and Medina, for they are made haram for me. Every time I come to them, the angels will stop me." And it is in Sahih Muslim, and its chain appears to be authentic. So we put this hadith in a footnote, and we have a question mark, and we leave it at that. Allah knows best. I don't know. But mainstream interpretation, Imam An-Nawawi, Ibn Kathir, these scholars, they consider this to be authentic because this is Sahih Muslim. Then the issue comes, how do you reconcile this with the other ahadith about the coming of Dajjal, shall be born at a later time, his parents shall be childless, etc., etc. And you have one of two opinions. The first of them is that time and space mean nothing to Allah. And so, Tamim Ad-Dari got lost in, let me speak in the language of Star Trek, and I'm a big fan of Star Trek when I was a child. They got lost in a different time warp. And so they traveled to a different time and place, and Allah is ala kulli shayin qadir. And they saw an image of Dajjal projected from the future back to their time frame. And the other interpretation is that Dajjal is in fact alive and healthy, and that he was born and all of this happened in the past, and then he is being chained and kept as the hadith of Tamim says, and he shall be released.
So this is an island located about 1 month's journey by sea using wind from the Arab world, the Mediterranean coast there by Syria. And it is an island with expertise in spying and espionage, you know. A hint for you, James Bond kind of stuff. And Jasasa pointed to the ruins of a monastery and said, "There's someone waiting for you there." So this is an island in which religion will eventually crumble, and churches are going to be sold, restaurants and discotheques and bingo halls. Churches on sale, because nobody going to church. And so they hurried. And when they got to the ruins of the monastery, they found this human being. He looks like a human being, but he's in chains. His hands are chained to his neck, and his feet are chained together. And he questions them. And they are very interesting questions. For that, you must read this book. And then he said, I am Dajjal. I am Dajjal. And when I am released, so up to this point in time, he's not as yet been released. This is about the second or third year after the Hijrah in Medina. When I am released, I'll enter every town and every city, but he didn't mention kampung. For our audience outside of Malaysia, kampung means village. So protection from Dajjal is better in the village, in kampung, than in the city. So when Dajjal is released, it will be from this island that he is going to commence his effort to rule the world from Jerusalem, from the Holy Land. Which island is it? I came to the conclusion that it was Britain. The Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, that when Dajjal is released, he will live on earth for 40 days. Don't make the mistake of counting 40 days as 1 month and 10 days or 1 month and 11 days. No. Don't do that. Someone asked the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, which was the first masjid which was built? He said, the one in Arabia, the Kaaba, by Ibrahim alayhi salam. And then someone asked him, which was the second masjid which was built by a prophet? He said, the one in Jerusalem, Masjid al-Aqsa, by Suleiman alayhi salam. And then he was asked, how much time elapsed between the construction of the two? He said, 40 years. He said, 40 years. When every single Arab, every single Arab in Arabia would know that it is far, far, far more than 40 years, but thousands of years in between. Obviously, when he said 40 years, he's speaking symbolically, symbolically. So when he says that Dajjal will live on earth for 40 days, do not take it literally, please. The 40 days, he says, one day would be like a year. He didn't say one day would be a year, did he? He said one day would be like a year. One day would be like a month. And one day would be like a week. And all the rest of his days would be like your days. So they subtract 3 from 40. Strange mathematics. And they get 37. So they said, when he is in our day like a year, our day like his day, he's going to live for 37 days. How can you be born and you still in your diaper after 37 days, still drinking your mother's milk, and yet become a young